Now let us recall what we have studied till now in the chapter. So first thing what we have studied in the chapter is natural numbers. What are natural numbers? The counting numbers are known as natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. These numbers are known as natural numbers. Now second thing what we have studied in the chapter, which is predecessors and successors. What are predecessors and what are successors? When we will add 1 to a natural number or a given number, when we will add 1 to that number, then we will get the successor of that number. Suppose the number is 2, when we will add 1 in 2, then we will get 3. When we will add 1 in 3, we will get 4. So when we will add 1 to any natural number, we will get the successor of that number. What are predecessors? Predecessors are when we will decrease, when we will subtract one number from the given number or from the natural number. Suppose the number is 4, when we will subtract 1 plus 4, it will give us 3. So 3 is the predecessor of 4. So when we will subtract 1 from any natural number or given number, we will get the predecessor of that number. Now what we can say about successor and predecessor is that every natural number has successor. Every natural number has successor. Suppose the number is 1, the successor of 1 is 2. Suppose the number is 50, the successor of 50 is 51. So every natural number has successor. But every natural number does not have predecessor, because all the numbers are having predecessor except 1. 1 does not have any predecessor. Predecessor of 1 will become 0. Why? Because we have to subtract 1 from the given number. The given number is 1. When we will subtract 1 from 1, what we will get? We will get 0. But 0 is not a natural number. 0 is a whole number. So natural number starts from 1 onwards. So every natural number has predecessor except 1. And every natural number has successor. So this we can see about predecessor and successors. What we have studied after predecessor and successor, we have studied whole numbers. What are whole numbers? When we will add 0 in the natural numbers, we will get the collection of whole numbers. So what are whole numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, etc. are known as whole numbers. Now every whole number has successor. 0, what is the successor of 0? The successor of 0 is 1. The successor of 1 is 2. The successor of 2 is 3 and so on. So every natural number has successor. But except 0, every natural number has predecessor. The predecessor of 1 will become 0. But what will be the predecessor of 0 will become nothing. It will come as a negative where it is not a whole number. So every natural number except 0 has predecessor and every natural number has successor. Now what we have studied after this, after whole numbers, we have studied number line. What is number line? We have to draw one line and we have to start writing the we have to draw a line and we have to draw the starting point as 0. We have to keep this point as 0 and we have to move further in the right side of the line. Here this will become 1, 2, 3 and 4 and so on. So this is known as number line, where the number will increase one by one, moving on the right side the number will increment one by one. Now what we can do in this number line, we can add any number in this number line, we can subtract any number in this number line, we can multiply any number in this number line. And now next we have properties. Properties in whole numbers. What are properties in whole numbers? How many properties are there? We have studied closure property, commutativity property, associative property and distributive property. Now what happens in closure property? Whole numbers are closed under addition and under multiplication. What does this mean? This means that if we add two numbers, so two whole numbers, suppose the number are 1 and 2. When we will add 1 and 2, what we will get? We will get 3 as the answer. So when two whole numbers are added, then we will get the answer as whole number. Answer also as whole number. And same for multiplication. If we have taken two numbers, suppose the numbers are 3 and 5. When we will multiply 3 into 5, what we will get? We will get the answer is as 15. And 3 is also a whole number, 5 is also a whole number, and 15 is also a whole number. So when we will multiply two whole numbers, numbers, we will get the product or we will get the answer also as whole number. So whole numbers are close under addition and under multiplication, whereas whole numbers are not close under subtraction and under division. And if any number is divided by zero, then the answer is not defined. If any number, suppose the number is 6, 6 is divided by 0, then the answer will be not defined. Answer will be not defined. We have seen the procedure also, how to, why we are saying that the answer is not defined, because when we will divide it, then the, when the divisor is subtracted with dividend, then the dividend will be the answer. Every time, in every step, we will get the dividend as the answer. Therefore, we have written that when any number is divided by zero, the answer will be not defined. Now, after closure property, what we have seen, commutativity. Commutativity property. What does this mean? This means that when we will add two numbers in any of the order, then we will get the same answer. Suppose we will add 2 and 3. 2 plus 3 will become 5, and 3 plus 2 will also become 5. So it does not matter. The arrangement of number does not matter in whole numbers. This is the commutativity property. Here two numbers can be arranged in any way, we will get the same answer. Then after commutativity, what we have seen? We have seen associative property. And commutative property will be for addition and as well as for multiplication. In multiplication also it follows that when we will multiply two numbers, suppose the number are 2 and 6, when we will multiply 2 into 6, we will get the answer as 12. And when we will rearrange the number, then 6 into 2, then also the answer will be 12. So it doesn't matter, the arrangement of number doesn't matter, and we will get the same answer. So for addition and for multiplication we can say so, but we cannot say that this will happen in subtraction and in division. So we know that commutativity property will be followed under addition and under multiplication, but not in division and subtraction. Now after this, what we have seen? We have seen 0 is the identity for addition. 0 is the identity for addition. What does this mean? This means that when we will add any number with 0, or when we will add 0 with any number, we will get the same whole number, as the answer. Suppose I am adding 0 with 8, I will get the answer as 8. Suppose I am adding 0 with 50, so then I will get the answer as 50. So 0 is the identity for addition in whole numbers, and 1 is the identity for multiplication in whole numbers. If I am going to multiply any number with 1, then I will get the same whole number as the answer. Suppose I am multiplying 16 with 1, then I will get the answer as 16. And if I am multiplying 1 with 56, then I will get the answer as 56. So 1 is the identity for multiplication and whole numbers. So we can say that 0 is additive identity for whole numbers, and 1 is multiplicative identity for whole numbers. Now for associative property, what we have seen, addition and multiplication are associative for whole numbers, and same we have seen for distributive. Addition and multiplication, multiplication over addition can be done in whole numbers. So what we can say, commutativity, associativity and distributive properties are very useful for the whole numbers. We can simplify the solution and we can solve it. We are using these properties, but we don't know that we are using that property. It automatically comes in the solution and it makes our solution easier. Now last, what we have seen in the last we have seen pattern. Last topic is pattern. What we have done in patterns, we have arranged the number in pattern and we have seen the solution. What are the use of patterns here. What, why we are using pattern? Pattern makes our problem, our solution easier, and we can make it simpler and solve it. It becomes interesting as well. So we can use a pattern in solving our questions. So we have seen all the properties, everything in the whole number. I think so you understood the chapter very well. If you have any doubt, please message on the WhatsApp group and I will give you the solution for that question. And now in the next video, we will start our next chapter, which is our third chapter, playing with numbers. Thank you.